So, today's meditation comes from Philemon 1, verse 7, and I'm reading from my NIV. Your love has given me great joy and encouragement, because you, brother, have refreshed the hearts of the Lord's people. One of the most absent ministries in the church today, I believe, is the ministry of encouragement. Paul frequently made reference to people who had helped him in his ministry and were a comfort and a help to him. Encouragers are so few and far between in the ministry. But encouragers, they soothe and they comfort our hearts. They give us hope, they give us energy, they give us confidence. You see, we all want to be on the receiving end of encouragement, and especially when it comes to the Lord's work. But we also need to be on the giving end. Over 30 times in the New Testament, we read of things we are to do for one another. Be kind to one another, love one another, encourage one another. Encouragement is a massive, huge gift to the body of Christ. And it's through this encouragement that we become a channel of His grace and His mercy and His love and His compassion and fire to the other parts of the body that so desperately need it. It's so easy just to assume that people are doing well. It's so easy to assume that people have got it all together. It's so easy to assume that someone else is doing the encouraging. But believer, today, be reminded of Paul. Constantly singled out men and women who helped him on his journey, that made his ministry a joy, which made his ministry possible, which made his mission effective. Where would Paul have been without all of these men and women of encouragement? Today, think about someone who needs encouraging, someone who could do with just a well done, someone who could just do with a thank you, someone who could just do with a hi, hope you're okay. Often we think of our ministry to be something big and elaborate, but without encouragement, those people around you might not just finish the course that God has set out before them. We each have a role and a part to play. So let's play it. Be an encourager today. Be used mightily in the hand of God as you speak the words of life to someone who needs it today.
I woke up this morning, saw a world full of trouble now. I thought, how do we ever get so far down? And how's it ever gonna turn around? So I turned my eyes to heaven. I thought, God, why don't you do something? Well, I just couldn't bear the thought of people living in poverty, children sold into slavery. The thought disgusted me, so I shook my fist at heaven. I said, God, why don't you do something? He said, I did. Yeah. I created you.
Now listen.
If not us, then who? If not me and you, right now. Well, it's time for us to do something. Tell ourselves it's alright.